Hello friends, welcome back. If you want to know what is BPMN and all the components of BPMN diagram, then you are watching the right video. Let's get started. BPMN stands for Business Process Model and Notation. It is a graphical representation for specifying processes in a business. It makes stakeholders understand the business process through visual representation. It is mostly used in software industry. To successfully draw BPMN diagram, it is very important to understand all the components of BPMN. There are four main components of BPMN, that is elements, connecting objects, gateways, pools and swim lines. Now, I will explain you each of these components in detail. First component is called element. BPMN diagrams are made of elements or shapes that comprises its visual language. There are three main elements used in BPMN, that is events, activities and artifacts. Now let us go through each of the element in detail. First type of element is called event. An event represents something that happens or triggers during the course of a process. There are three types of events, that is start events. Start events are those which occurs at the beginning of the process, and every process starts with an event. Intermediate events are those which occur in the middle of the process between the activities. And end events are those which occurs at the end of the process. And every process has at least one end event. We can also use icons inside these events to give more clarity. For example, we can use message icon to show that a message is needed to start a process. Likewise, we can use other icons like condition icon and clock icon. Next type of element is called activities. Activities are building blocks of BPMN. It shows specific tasks performed by a person or a system within the business process. There are four main types of activities used in BPMN diagrams. That is, task. Task is a single action that occurs in a business process, which cannot be broken down further. It is represented by rectangular shape. We can also use icons to show what kind of task it is, whether it is a user task or manual task or any other task. Next task is sub-process. Sub-process is a group of tasks that fit together particularly well. For example, all the tasks involved in admission process of a student in a school software can be grouped in a sub-process. Next is transaction. It is a specified sub-process that involves payment. Next is call. It is a global sub-process that is reused at various points in the business flow. Next type of element is called artifacts. BPMN artifacts can be used to include additional information about a process. There are three types of artifacts: data objects, group and annotation. There are four kinds of data objects, that is data input, which shows that data is placed to the process or the task. Next is data output, which shows data resulting from the process or the task. Next is data collection, which shows that data is collected from the process or task. Next is data storage, which shows that data is stored in the process or the task. Next kind of artifact is group, which is similar to sub-process. So that is group of tasks that fit together particularly well. For example, all the tasks involved in admission process of a student can be grouped in a sub-process. Next is annotation. Annotation provides further explanation to a part of diagram. So this is used to show or highlight some parts of the BPMN diagram. Second component of BPMN diagram is called connecting objects. Connecting objects are the lines present in every BPMN diagram. They are used to show the order of activities to be performed. There are three kinds of connecting objects used. One is sequence flow. It shows the main order of activity to be performed. Next is message flow. This is to show that message flows from across the pools. You will understand what is pools in the further slides. Association. This is nothing but to show the relationship between the artifacts and the flow objects. The third component of BPMN is called gateways. BPMN gateways are the decision points that can adjust the path of a flow in the process based on the certain condition. They are represented by diamond shape. They dictate the flow of the process. There are 7 types of gateways in BPMN, in which 5 of them are most commonly used. So let us see those 5 gateways in detail. Exclusive gateway. An exclusive gateway is used when only one alternative path can be taken in the process based on the condition. In the above example, you see if the invoice amount submitted by the customer is more than 20,000, then CFO approval is required. If it is less than 20,000, manager approval is required. So only one path can be taken. An exclusive gateway is being represented with the into symbol, the cross symbol in the diamond shape. Next is inclusive gateway. An inclusive gateway specifies that one or more of the available parts can be taken. In the above example, shipping of goods can be done either by air or by sea transport, or by both air and sea transport. So delivery note will be prepared once the goods arrive. So it can take either one path or both the path. Next is event-based gateway. An event-based gateway is similar to an exclusive gateway where only one path can be taken. But here a path is taken based on event, not based on the condition. So in the above example, there are 2 events. One is the condition event where if you see the bus, you travel. Another event is clock event. If the 15 minutes elapsed, then you don't travel. So either of the event will be executed. Next is parallel gateway. In parallel gateway, you don't evaluate any condition or event. Instead, it is used to represent 2 concurrent tasks in the business flow. In the above example, when the customer applies for home loan, both checking the credit score and reviewing documentation task will be done in parallel without waiting for any condition or the event. Next is parallel event-based gateway. It is similar to parallel gateway, but here instead of task, it is used to represent 2 concurrent events in the business flow. Now the 4th component of BPMN is called pools and swimlines. Pools represent major participant of the organization in the process. And swim lines represent each participant responsible for the particular flow. As you can see in the diagram here, car showroom is a pool. An admin and sales team are the participants inside the showroom. It is not always mandatory to have multiple participants in the pool. Now, let us see an example of BPMN diagram. Here, as you can see, there are 2 pools. One is the Chinese restaurant, which has 3 lanes, that is driver, chef, and cashier. And the other pool is customer, which has no lanes inside. In this diagram, you can see that there is a start event, there is an end event, several tasks. That is, all the rectangular boxes are tasks. We have a gateway and we have the connecting objects that connects task, one task to other task. Here, in this example, the first task is the customer calls the Chinese restaurant and will request for the wait time. Meanwhile, the cashier in the Chinese restaurant answers the phone call and will give the wait time. So we use dotted lines when we connect tasks from one pool to another pool. So once the customer receives the request time, then we use the gateway to see that if there is a long wait, the event will be ended. That means the customer will not place an order. If there is no long wait, then he will place an order. The cashier will process the order and the chef prepares the food and the food is packed and the driver will deliver the food to the customer. So after the food is collected by the customer pays the food, pay for the food and the driver will collect the payment and the event is ended for the driver from the Chinese restaurant. So the customer will eat the food and goes back. The event is ended. Thank you very much, friends. Please like and subscribe to my video. Thank you.